In Bloxburg, we're all obsessed with having mansions. But the other day, someone commented, build a 6x6 house. And so you know me, I found this. So in today's video, we are building a 6x6 tiny home. Also, if you're wondering why I sound like Voldemort, I'm very sick right now, but I couldn't let you guys go too long for a video. And let's get building. So if we really appreciate the picture on screen now, we can kind of see that it's actually in the basement. So although it's a 6x6 house, I'm gonna make the basement a little bit bigger so we can make some cool scenery and stuff. I cannot get over how I sound. I'm literally like Yoda.
If your knees are bruised.
Anyway, I think lush grass, or maybe it's a normal grass. Actually, I didn't even know we had two grass types. I reckon pine cone. We want it to be like really not obvious. Now is the moment of truth. Where is the house gonna go? I hope I made this even actually. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I did. And wow, this isn't actually that tiny. I was like, I thought this was gonna be well smaller.
That's quite big.
I think we even might have to extend the basement at this early stage. And if you can notice, there's actually stairs and it looks like there's a balcony out the back. So maybe it might end up being smaller than I thought, because after all, it does just have to be in the 6x6 square. And then would you guys mind if I like made it extend out a tiny bit at the front here? Do you know, I'm adding my little extra box because it's kind of like we've snipped it off here and put it there. So the main sort of chunk of this appears to have a flat roof. And then this one here is like a real, it got really chunky, chunky. We'll put that there. Does that looks so flat. What? And then, but at the back, there's like a slanted roof. So I might as well just add this because, you know, we're going rogue. We're going rogue. This looks so futuristic. For my stairs, then, I guess we're going to use these ones, the left floating stairs. And of course, my balcony. I'm so excited for this because y'all know I love a woodland cabin vibe. And if you're wondering, Reese's, if you're this sick, why didn't you just take a day off? I can't. I cannot take a day off, guys. In literally 3 days, I have like 3 exams. So it really is the worst time for me to be getting sick. But hopefully I'll be okay tomorrow, guys. Please just wish me well in the comments. And oh my gosh, wait, why is adding stairs actually like revolutionize this? So I guess now we'll pick the colors. We've got like white wood and then brown wood. And oh my gosh, guys, complete side note while I'm decorating this. Did you guys see? I don't know if it was real. I saw it on Twitter. Apparently there's going to be a Bloxburg update on this date. I forgot it, but this is what it said. Apparently it's Bloxburg becoming free, but I don't know. Underneath here, we need to put my garage door, and I'm actually going to put the small horizontal one because, oh, we could use this actually. That one's actually even a little bit nicer. So look, I'm not going to add that, am I? We're a little lame. And then for our front door, maybe this. Window wires. We're going to, I should not be trying to do funny voices today. It kind of looks like there's like a square one here, which I'm really liking. And you guys know it is so me to do this anyway. Outlining with some structural beams. And a lot of you guys were telling me, Reese's, it actually saves a bit of money if you color them first. I just know, guys, I'm going to wake up with the sorest throat tomorrow. Normally when people are sick, they like relax on the sofa, have a nice soup. I'm screaming at Bloxburg. And wow, that really does look so different to anything I've done before. I'm loving the ones along this side though. And I feel like with something like this, it doesn't actually matter if it's 100% even. I feel like as long as it looks mostly, it's fine. And of course the star of the show is gonna be the window that goes here because this is gonna be like the full length window almost. And I'm guessing we'll put the bedroom here because we've got to have it something luxury, haven't we? Bada bing, bada bomb, we've got the most aesthetic 6x6 house you have ever blimmin' seen, people. So just before we go inside, I guess the outside is going to be pretty straightforward to decorate. And of course, we're going to be using my iconic slate texture. The rest of the ground, I think, will make our nice green. And I should use this grass more often. For some reason, I thought this lush grass here had replaced it.
You can't get rid of me.
Oh, that looks absolutely gorgeous. And then we'll delete these white lines so it doesn't look ridiculous. And also, I don't really know where like this is going. I feel like it's a bit more for aesthetics. And look at these trees, this foresty shrubbery, whatever you want to call it, is what really drew me into this. So we're going to be using pine trees, but the gigantic ones. So my little other building hack here anyway is going to be to make the basement a little bit bigger. Of course, this is just temporary. And then we want them to kind of stick through. I just don't want to see the stem. All I know is that I just spent $30,000 on trees.
$30,000?
And if you think we're done yet, we are not done. I think I'm gonna add some palm trees. And oh my gosh, this looks interesting, to say the least. Oh my god, I look so... What are you staring at up there? My little avatar's a creep. What are you staring at? And then where we have the gaps, we can just expand a compact bush into its mutant form. You guys can all agree, especially if you watch the channel a lot, this is one of my most aesthetic exteriors. I'm loving this. Hashtag thumbnail vibes. We can now go inside. This looks so sick. So, oh my gosh, this is actually going to be such a quick video. I actually think this garage door is going to be more of like an open window, because if we were to add a garage in here, like, first of all, we can't. Second of all, that's going to take up like half the house. So I think we should have it as like one of those indoor, outdoor living things. And as you can see, we now have like a little bit of indoor, outdoor living. And wait a damn minute.
Wait a damn minute.
There is so much more space up here than I thought. Oh my gosh, we can have such a big bedroom and bathroom and closet. And if you're wondering what today's snack of the day is, guys, paracetamol. Yeah, I think I actually have tonsillitis is what I have. Also, I've like unintentionally... Wait, what the hell was going on here? I've like unintentionally made a really cool feature wall over here. So as you walk in, what do you normally have? Well, I'd normally have like a dresser or a hat stand or something. Oh my gosh, please go in. Please go in. We've got to get it like in the exact place. Come on. Oh wait, can't I just do that? Let's add roses. Do you know what? The kind of vibe I'm getting from this is that it might be like a romantic Valentine's Day Airbnb or something. And I'm just changing everything like ever so slightly. And also I might add a, like a little dash of something like this on the wall. Ooh la la. So as I also said, we should probably pop in a hat stand or something. Although I don't know how, what kind of bougie person's gonna be staying in this tiny house. We've got our hat stand and our umbrellas. And I normally put a hoover as well, to be honest. I definitely think we are in need of a fireplace. And then just by the side here, I might add a little armchair. I don't know why, I'm just feeling it. So here we'll have my pillow, absolutely gorgeous. And now I guess we should do the kitchen so we know how much room we have left for the lounge. So I definitely think this cubby here is perfect for a kitchen because it basically has no windows in it. And if we're going to be using cabinets and stuff, we obviously don't want many windows. And I don't know about you guys, but the Craftsman cabinets have been calling my name today. And of course, an island bench. Now, so many American houses, even tiny flats, have island benches. Whereas in England, it is so rare to have an island bed. That's just something I noticed about you guys in America. Does that look good or vile? I kind of think it's actually kind of nice. And lately, guys, I've been obsessed with concrete. It is actually flipping amazing. This is intriguing. This is intriguing, guys. I'm learning to use nicer words when I don't like something. Normally, I'd say, this looks like a piece of crap. But since I built it, I'm going to be a little nicer. Now, I am going to add some sticks here. Oh, sorry, pillars. You guys are telling me to... You just text me.
Who dare to call me?
Oh, it's my grandmother, guys. Bear with. Okay, I'm back. She was just texting me a lovely message like, hope you feel better. I love grannies. They are just like perfect thing in the world, aren't they? They're always looking after you when you're sick. And the thing is with tiny houses, they basically have everything a normal house has, except they'll add it in like tiny ways. So instead of having my normal three pendants, we'll have two little ones. That looks insatiably good. I have no idea what the word insatiable means. And then on this back wall here, we're so adding a decal. But I suppose we should actually decorate the kitchen walls first, because otherwise we might run out of space. There we go. And since I don't want to clutter this up too much, I think underground... Oh, wait. We're in the basement. Oh, gosh. I am actually going to have to add lights, guys. And we can hide one in the fridge, or we can actually hide several in the fridge. Oh, yeah, babes. So, the appliances, I probably shouldn't be putting things like a food warming tray in here. It's like the biggest waste of space ever. Also, we should add a sink. Now, don't worry, because if we were to put it here, obviously it would mess up. But... it has actually been a hot minute since I have used my gorgeous custom sink. But honestly, that is such a cute kitchen. It has literally everything you need in there. And now we know how much room we have for the lounge. So obviously we can't really put too much of a sofa along this back wall. And then what chairs could we use? Perhaps, oh, I know what ones. I absolutely love these. I feel like one day I should maybe like rank my top favorite furnitures. I'm just gonna do very like neutral colors, but the pillows are where that the adventure is gonna sort of start. For my end tables, chickens, I think we should use these. I love this. Although I think I might switch on the table lamp to be maybe these ones are giving a little bit more beauty, let's say. And I love that I put that window in there. That is actually beautiful. So we'll finish up this downstairs bit then with like a light or something in the corner. And I've just fathomed as we go upstairs, we can also, of course, we can all sort of have this awesome segue of like a giant glass window. Up here is of course going to be the bedroom, closet and bathroom. But just before we get to that, why don't we add in my hot tub? Or is it called jacuzzi? I did not know they were this big. We might actually have to use a bath instead. You're going to have to literally be a skinny legend to fit in here. But you know, it's kind of cute. And then we'll add a couple of chairs, or maybe one chair. And then we can have a chair down by the fountain. These lines on the roof are very triggering to me. So I am going to have to slightly and move them. And guys, by the way, I've pre-filmed this video, so hopefully, fingers crossed, next time that you hear me, hopefully I'll be sounding back to my usual chipper, jolly self. And we're gonna, yes, be having a fountain shower because we just are that cool. And wait, why is the green, white, and blue such a nice combo? And maybe the ottoman should go on this side where it can be moved out of the way of the door. And then over here should be the more solid items like the toilet, which I will stock generously with the towels. When I say generously, I literally mean one. How magical does that look? So I like that the bathroom's actually a separate room. That looks really, really nice. The closet then, let's have as soon as you come up here. And we're going to use the modern closets. Wait, it's not called modern. Wait, guys, let me think. Big brain. Stylish. It's called stylish. Not me memorizing the Bloxburg item catalog. As well as, of course, a mirror. Because we're going to need to be looking absolutely slay, slay, slay. Let's get building my gorgeous bed. And wait, Hurricane Gray comes through. It has been a hot minute since I've showed you guys how to do bedding. So basically, I think today I might do 4 big ones because then I always recommend only colouring maybe 3 the colour and leaving the rest white. It leaves something to be desired. Now, I used to add slippers at the end all the time. What happened to that trend? That was such a cute thing I used to do, Reese's. And then we're left with like this tiny bit here. So, oh, do you know what we should do? A library. That is not obvious to do. And yeah, anyway, let's add my desk in. I think we'll add a hairpin. That might have been the most pathetic hairpin singing I've ever done. So add my lamp in. And again, I think I might hide some of these fancy lamps, maybe like inside of my closet.
Honey, you've got a big storm coming.
And with that, guys, my 6x6 house is built. Let's go look around. Okay, guys, so I want you all to comment down below your guesses. No cheating. $182,000. But I actually think that is so reasonable for a tiny house. So from the outside, I first of all just want to say, like, this snapshot alone looks gorgeous. And actually, compared to our inspo pic, they look very similar. Not that that was the idea of this video, but it just sort of looks really, really cool. So of course, on the outside, we do actually have some things. We have the sun. We also have my patio area with these rocking chairs, which is low-key, like, creepy. But imagine just coming home and, like, some old gran is just rocking here. In the back, we do actually have swings. I wonder which way they face. Ah, kind of looks like they're swinging from under the stairs. That is so cute. And then round here is, of course, the driveway. So I didn't add any cars, and normally that would be closed. You can either get in from going upstairs to our hot tub area, which I suppose we could relax here now. Bubbles, bubbles, bubbles. And we get a sneak peek to the inside, but let's go back down for a second and open up the gates to heaven. When I had this idea, I thought this was going to be kind of a lame video, but this is actually amazing. So as you can see behind me, you sort of get like an overview of everything, although this does look a little bit weird. But first of all, in here we have the entryway, which is actually kind of big, and I love like the hippie vibe I did here. This is my lounge, so you can technically have a guest here who can sleep on the sofa. Maybe this goes into a sofa bed, and that's another thing I want Bloxburg to add. Actually, a sofa bed would be cool. And then over here is our kitchen. I don't know why I love the two pendants. Feels like they're meant for each other. They say that the world was built for two. As we go upstairs then, this is what we just did. It should be fresh on the mind. Once again, it sort of can be seen as open planned. And I love, love, love the closet, although you can see the lamps. Over here is my bed, looking absolutely stunning, shmunning, warning. And then my desk area. So we can sit here and we can answer some emails or whatever I'm going to do there. And then finally, we have the bathroom, which is one of my favorite bathrooms I think I've ever done. I really do hope you guys enjoyed watching this video. I'm so sorry about my voice. Subscribe if you had a fun time. Thanks for watching, chickens. And I'll see you all in the next one. Bye.